Mate with unity. Mate with love. The content of this video game is purely fictional. It's not intended to blah blah blah. There's also photosensitive seizures. Be careful. Don't get epileptic seizures. Everyone, welcome to the coziest game I've ever played in my life, which was Life is Strange, until it got dark, tense, and very scary. So this is the prequel. It's called Before the Storm, and I think I accidentally deleted Life is Strange from my channel. Well, I say accidentally, I got rid of it because it wasn't very good. I could re-upload it. Maybe I will. But yes, this is Life is Strange Before the Storm, and it serves as a prequel to the previous one. I love the settings, by the way. If you go to video settings, everything's hella high. Ooh. Look at, oh wait, no, give me hella high. Let's see. Look, I love how good this little slider looks. Anyway, yep, that's good. Game setting? No, why would I ever want inverted stuff? Alright, let's go to the episodes. There's only three, and you get Awake, Brave New World, and Hell is Empty, which is coming out on the 20th of December. It's currently the 9th. I am woke, as the kids would say. It's Awake. So, this game takes place... Life is Strange Before the Storm is a story-based game that will feature player choice. The consequences of your actions and decisions will impact the world around you. Choose wisely. Is that you, Chloe? Oh, that is... This is 1337. Who? Okay. Stop. Chloe, you stupid bitch. Why would you ever do that?
I can't believe Firewalk is playing a show at the old mill. Fuck yes.
Fuck yeah.
Mom would kill me if she knew I was out here.
No camera controls. So, nope, there's camera controls now. Wait, what? Nah. So, you've got the slow walk and you got the fast walk. So yeah, this is Life is Chloe. Fence. Game looks good, man. Game looks really good. Warning, no trespassing private property. Jump the fence. I'm so fucking... Oh, fuck you, fence.
Holy shit.
Look at that 30 FPS fire. Oh, don't look at it. Take your mind away. Just stop.
This place is awesome.
Is it?
If I'm gonna get inside, I'll have to get through that door.
Machinery.
That saw looks ancient. I wonder how long ago the mill actually closed.
Boys? Gross.
Those guys need to get a room.
Eh, you...
Or not. Damn.
Mind your own business.
Little bitch slapped on that man.
I understand, really, and it won't ever happen again.
This RV's just begging for a little street art. But if I do it here, someone will see me.
Trust with me.
Can I?
In action.
Could probably avoid getting on that guy's shit list. Some say the world will end in fire.
Ponder.
Mom would totally flip her shit if she knew I hiked for an hour just to see a show.
Yeah, Mom.
This place is sketchy as hell. An old abandoned building in the middle of nowhere, miles from home.
Sketchy shit. Okay.
Home. Right. Now I remember why I'm here. Any place is better than home.
Oh, it just reminds me of the fact that Chloe's dad died.
Guess fire safety isn't exactly high on the agenda here.
Can I? Yeah.
Ah, perfect place for me to work.
Draw a dick.
Now what to draw?
Penis. Not a meth lab. Not a meth lab sounds cool.
I got definitely, absolutely not a meth lab.
I got an achievement called recreational art. I think it said recreational art. Yeah. So, oh shit to tag. Okay. Definitely not a meth lab. Something sharp, lost unicorn, David's shit, and prison wall. Drama nerds, moving canvas, dead white guy, happy brat, and the old car. Oh, look at Max. My name is Chloe Price, but you can call me that big old middle finger. I'm going to read this, by the way. I am an inmate at Blackwell Academy, currently serving a 4-year sentence for crimes against maternity. That would be my mom, Joyce, who seems endlessly disappointed in me. Which I get. I mean, I'm no one's image of a perfect daughter, or student, or anything really. But who the fuck wants to be perfect? I'm surrounded all day by so-called perfection, and it sucks ass. Other things that suck, mom's new drill sergeant boyfriend, David. How hard is it to buy weed around here? Having to know friends, hypocrites, country music, people who say chillax, dad being dead. It's been 2 years since he died in a car crash. I still think about him all the time. I've even been having these weirdly lifelike dreams. Sometimes I think he's trying to tell me something. Other times, I just, you know, remember he's feeding worms in a ditch right now, and anything is just a fairy tale to make myself feel better. Look at those little worms. Oh, Chloe. At least I have two weapons to help me survive this shitbird town. The pen I used to tag, and everything I want. Tag any and everything I want, and my shining personality. If I work at it, maybe I can leave this place just a little less perfect than when I found it. Despite mom's best efforts, I don't actually hate her. I know shit's been rough since dad died. Money's tight, her job as a waitress at a diner isn't exactly glamorous, and I'm clearly not about the whole going to school thing. But why does she have to make things so much harder on the both of us? She acts as if I smoke pot or when I skipped out to go catch an awesome show, it's somehow a personal attack on her. She should be happy that I'm self-medicating and not going postal on everyone. She never used to be this way when dad was around. She could actually be cool. But lately there's a hairy dick monster that she let into the house. That's fucking everything up. David Mattson, a jobless, brainless, dickless little shit with a hard-on for the military and promised to whip me to shape. Asshole. It's like a dick sergeant. Look. I tried to express these concerns to mom. Yet, every week it seems the virus spreads to yet another corner of her life. I'm starting to worry that David's flu is kind of a disease that kills its host. Okay. Is that... Yep. So you got two pages, right? Wait, is that... Oh, okay, no. That's just another one. Max Caulfield. MIA ex-best friend extraordinaire. This artsy motherfucker loves photographs, photography more than life itself, and definitely more than me. She even uses old instant cameras. It's probably not healthy for anyone to be stuck in the past, but who am I to tell people how to live their lives? When we were kids, we would dress up like pirates, eat ice cream, write and draw these stupid comic books where we had powers and save people and shit. Then my dad died and her dad got some job up north. She moved away to Seattle. It was probably the moment when I needed her the most. She bailed. Thanks, Max, for teaching me I can't rely on anyone. I mean it. Life lesson learned. The worst part is that even though we haven't spoken in months, even though she's habitually ignoring my texts so much that I just stopped trying, even though I know deep down that she doesn't care about me anymore, and that she probably has all new friends in fucking Seattle, still miss her. She came back tomorrow and said, "Hey Chloe, wanna dress up and be pirates and be stupid together?" I'd take her back in a heartbeat. Loved up in a heartbeat. Chloe, you are so sweet. If I had a nickel back for every jerk off guidance counselor or therapist who tries to get me to write shit about Dad over the last year, I would never have to buy weed from Frank again. What's the matter? Don't want to write about your dear old dad? I guess they think it helps me cope with the feeling or whatever. As if a few paragraphs about how great Dad was could help me forget that his guts are probably plastered to the underside of a semi-truck. And what the fuck am I supposed to write anyway? That he was the perfect dad who was always fun around and never angry? That he treated me like an equal? That he was constantly working to make our lives better? That he could always make me laugh even when I was being a bitch? That he sang in the shower and hated hypocrisy? And that his barbecue grill is still rusting in the backyard because the thought of either throwing it away or ever using it again is so painful that it's easier for Mum and me to just pretend like neither of us notice it. If that's coping can go fuck itself. Alright, so whatever. What's this? Max. So, you know how I stopped going to class so much, like you stopped talking to me so much? Funny story, the trouble coming up with an excuse, so I just did. Just didn't show up. And it's fine, nobody said anything to me. Crazy, right? It's like I'm invincible all of a sudden. Maybe that's the perk of being the dead dad's girl. No one knows what to do with me, so they're actually relieved when I stay at home. Wish I figured this out sooner. Think of all the wasted school time. P.S. Pris from Blade Runner popped into my head the last time I rubbed one. I mean, at first I was thinking about Deckard, and that smolder of his, but then Pris totally stole the show. Probably nothing there. I think I just want her bangs. Chloe the Electric Sheep. Oh my god, there's a lot of things in this one. Dear Max, Dad got me the stationery one day when I complained about wanting to send an email and the internet was down. And tonight, I thought, hey, maybe it's time to write to Max. Funny thing is, I don't really know what to say, because we haven't talked in 3 months despite all my calls and texts. And not that I'm upset or anything. Fuck, there's no way I'm sending this, is there? Chloe the Unfriended. Oh my god, okay, that's page 3. Okay, Max. Now, this is more like it. Here I can write to you all I want without ever wondering if you're gonna or worrying if you're gonna write back. Maybe one day when you return home and apologize for having forgotten all about me and we kiss and make up, I'll show this to you and we can read it all and laugh. Or maybe I'll decide that the journal Max is way cooler than reality Max. And you just live in here forever as my imaginary, former, current best friend pen pal. Time will tell. Chloe the journal boss. Ready? So, Mom suggests taking a road trip next summer, and I'm cool. I'm like, cool, I guess. But then she starts talking about David being there. Yes, that David, the wannabe drill sergeant who swooped in on Mom and has stuck around like a bad zit. David, the mustache monster from Planet Dipshit. That fucking David. Anyway, I politely suggested to Mom that perhaps it was too early to assume that David would be in the picture by then. Or breathing. Hey, shit. Sorry. Hey, shit happens. As you might imagine, that didn't go over well. But really, if this guy's still around in 3 months, if this guy's still around for three months from now, then she's got serious self-esteem issues. And I got serious self-immolation. Look it up, nerd. Plans. Literally, I want to burn myself. She can do better. That's all I meant. She didn't want to hear it. Like, I'm the asshole. Chloe, the asshole. All these locks. Look at... Will you be joining us for supper? No thanks. Will you be coming home at some point tonight? Oh shit, okay. The scroll... up is not up and down, is the scroll is the analog. Spanish test sucked. Lucky if I pass. Aw. Lo siento. Cool. Not much, got shit to do later. Fucking Elliot is the Warren. Wow, that's a shit tier. Hell yeah. But tapped out, sorry, y'all lost. Hey, can you hold it for me for a day? Can I? Favorite customer, are you? You holding? He's still low. You do drugs over this phone. It is 420. I can meet you if you have the cash. Rent check. Wow. Holy shit. Yo, it's Max. How's it going? You there? Cool. Maybe some hitchhiking in my future. Hey, hippie. Oh. Max wasn't being a good friend.
This place has collected a lot of junk over the years. A second door inside? So close, and yet so far.
Oh, Chloe.
This band shreds so hard. I gotta get in there.
Yeah, this game looks really, really good.
I'd join a motorcycle gang if I had any friends. Nothing says badass like a nice floral print.
Bouncer. Hey, tribal tattoo man, can you let me in?
I've got to figure out how to get past this guy.
Help you, miss?
You gotta let me in. Check it. I'm totally legit.
It's not a bad fake, kid. But you're in over your head here. Do yourself a favor and scram.
Dude, what the fuck, man?
Can't let him push me around. Should I go back and stand up to him? Or can something around here help me convince him?
Fucking gas can into the fire. Oh, let me talk to him again. Dude.
God, again? What do you want, kid?
What's the... Your bike.
Is that your bike over there?
Yup.
It's, pretty cool.
Gee, thanks. Is that all?
The mill.
This is the old mill, right? I heard Firewalk is playing here tonight. They're awesome.
Nope.
Are you kidding?
You should probably just go.
Never mind.
Yeah, keep walking.
Can I get these assholes to fight each other?
Should probably avoid getting on that guy's shit list.
I guess I'm gonna have to, like, talk to him and say, let me in.
God, again? What do you want, kid?
You started a Backtalk challenge.
I have to convince this doorstop that I'm not giving up until he lets me inside.
In Backtalk, use arguments and insults to get someone to do what you want. Alright.
Don't you remember what it's like to be a teenager? I just want to see the band.
I thought we went over this. Isn't it past your bedtime?
No, it's past your bedtime. Pay attention to what your opponent says. Opponent. It says bedtime. Your bedtime?
Aww. Isn't it past yours?
Real cute. But I still don't know you.
Again, listen to your opponent's words. cute. I don't do cute.
Look at my face. Do I look cute? Or do I look like I'm going to kick your ass?
Oh, Chloe.
Okay, kid. I get it. You're tough.
Tough, huh? Not a kid.
I am not a damn kid. Other things I'm not. Young lady, kiddo, chica, sweet cakes.
A girl like you? I can't protect you in there.
I don't need your protection. Flowers on your bike?
A girl like you with pretty, pretty flowers on her bicycle shouldn't lecture me on what I can do.
That is a traditional Samoan... Look, my boss decides who gets in, all right?
Who's your boss?
Is your boss your mom? Follow up. Do you live in your boss's basement?
You're not accepting no for an answer, are you?
Nope.
And you really think you can take me?
Yep.
What if I had a knife?
No problem.
A gun?
Don't care.
What if I had...
You could have a flamethrower, an army of robot ninjas, and a motherfucking dragon on a leash in there, and I'd still kick your ass.
I give up. You're all right, kid. Go on.
Thanks, dude. I talked him into letting me in. What a fucking jerkwad. What a pushover. Alright. Alright. That's cool. Man gave me the chance to go in and I took it.
This is intense!
Jesus fucking Christ.
Come.
Cute dog.
Evil moose. That's where I'm drawing my shit. Jesus Christ, this place
just
is a dump.
Just follow the lights and the sound. Can't wait to get in there and thrash.
Hang on a sec.
How can you just chill when Firewalk is tearing it up in the next room?
T-shirt vendor.
Yeah, I mean...
Hey, are you selling
20
any...
bucks.
What?
20 bucks for a t-shirt.
That's really expensive. Dick.
No.
Skeevy guys.
Sketch Central.
Take.
Drink more, feel less. Yes, please.
Saw blade, that's fucking metal.
Graffiti everywhere. I think.
No one's seeing. Spin.
Sit and spin.
That doesn't look too great, Chloe. Yeesh.
That's totally me in 5 beers. Okay, 3.
Right.
Sober up, girl. You're missing the show. That dog is fierce.
Pep.
What's her name?
Delia.
Aww.
She doesn't usually like people.
I'm not usual people.
Yeah. Me neither.
So...
Half those stairs are rotted through. Looks dicey.
Frank?
Frank Bowers? What is he doing here?
God damn it.
Yo, Frank!
Hey!
Chloe?
I know your name, you idiot. You bought pot for me every month for a year. Look at that getup. Studs. You're trying too hard. What are you even doing here?
I'm here to see Firewalk, man. They rock.
How'd you even hear about this little shindig?
Shindig?
The internet. How else?
Seriously? Fucking kids.
Give me weed.
Okay, so you holding? I could definitely use something to take the edge off.
Of course. As soon as you give me the 175 bucks you owe me.
Jeez, shit.
Do I really owe him that much? Unless I find some quick cash around here, I can kiss my high goodbye.
Spot me some?
How about you spot me some? You know I'm good for it.
No way. I learned my lesson last time. Money first.
Fuck.
Never mind then.
Suit yourself.
Well,
reminds me of the way I make important life choices. No thanks. I try to avoid hepatitis when I can.
Well, that's a skeevy place, all right.
Classy.
Very. All right, let's go. Push through.
Here we go.
You okay?
I'm fine.
Relax. You bumped into me, remember?
Blow him off.
Fuck off, man.
Hey, you don't know who I am, do you?
No. And I give zero shits.
Hey, let me know how that works out for you, bitch.
Yeah.
All right. Mosh pit is a no-go. Fine. Maybe I can get a better view of the action from up above.
Okay, alright, new dialogue unlocked.
If you don't have 20 bucks, beat it.
Still a dick.
New dialogue with who?
Don't mess with Damon. Thanks for the memo.
Right, Frank.
She returns.
Who's that guy I pissed off?
Did you see that guy I ran into? Acted like I was supposed to know who the hell he was.
Yeah. I know him. He works for Damon.
Damon Merrick?
I see you've heard of him. This is his place. Damon's a friend of mine.
Where do those stairs go?
Up?
All right, wise ass.
Real helpful, Frank. I mean, will I get a better view of the band up there?
Oh, the fuck should I know? Floor above's rotted all to hell, okay? No one goes up there.
Fine. I'll see you later.
Whatever.
I'm gonna get my money.
Don't you judge me, spooky deerhead. I'm here for the band.
Oh. Guess I'm going up then. It's gonna break, isn't it?
Fuck, yes! Finally made it! I can't believe it!
Dancing by herself upstairs. Just let this sink in a little. Fuck off. This is awesome, by the way. Oh,
you spilled my beer, bitch!
You should be more careful. It's a rough place.
I don't like your attitude.
Insult.
Then how about I show you how unimpressed I am with limp dick assholes who get butthurt over a spilled beer?
I think she's calling us out, dude.
She's gonna regret every word. Every word.
Oh, this is gonna be good.
I'm gonna teach this little punk some manners.
I'm serious. You wanna see me get angry here? Because I'm getting there. And it won't be pretty. It won't.
She thinks she can take you?
Hey, dickhead.
Attack. Oh.
Rachel?
Oh boy.
Come on. Hurry up. I'm caught up in the traps of you slurring against a voice you feel the pain.
Lost. No one gave it toss. The note took us on superstone. Let me go, Frank.
Not gonna happen. Calm down. Come on, man. Walk away. Screw this.
Oh.
Bullshit. Get the fuck out of here.
This is so loud. Like, in my ears, it's bursting at the seams. Oh, thank God it's over. Yeah. We found Rachel Amber. Great! Just great!